My name is Juergen Grunert. I am the chairman of the German Ehlers-Danlos Patient Organization, and I am the co-chair of the medium-sized Arteries Working Group.
My name is Charissa Frank. I am the chairman of bentwezel.ba, the hereditary connective tissue disorders for the Flemish-speaking part in Belgium. And I am the deputy co-chair of also the MSA work group.
Together we are also working for ReConnect. At the moment, 13 types of Ehlers-Danlos syndromes are identified. A new one has been determined recently. Today we are talking about vascular EDS.
Within the 24 European reference networks, the ERNs, the vascular EDS is attached to VASCERN. The other EDS types are attached to ReConnect. This is the structure of VASCERN, where vEDS is part of the medium-sized arteries work group, or the MSA-WG.
And we as patient advocates are a very important part of this working group. We are participating in every decision and in every agenda point.
EDS is not curable, it's only treatable. They are in need of multidisciplinary care. It is very often not available local. They have to travel a very distance, which will make it also very expensive.
Charissa, what do you think are the major unmet needs for vEDS patients?
Little or most educational needs or information are not available to professionals, patients, or physicians. And these should be made available.
But do you know that the working group has already produced some pills of knowledge, so-called short videos for educational purposes? And to help the clinicians, there have been produced patient pathways, which can help to determine which kind of treatment or cure is best.
To improve the quality of life, the needs of patients are very often misunderstood. This is because they are very invisible.
Yes, but with the help of do and don't fact sheets, maybe we can solve this problem.
Psychological follow-up is sometimes also needed. This is because the long road to diagnosis is sometimes very long. It's also can also be very traumatic due to events, and also because it also can lead to anxiety and depression.
Yes, I think we have to raise more awareness for this rare condition, for vascular EDS. This is very important.
I'm very glad to hear that we are working, or that there is work in progress to work towards these needs for patients.
For more information, please regularly visit our website vascern.eu, our accounts on Twitter and Facebook and LinkedIn.
And don't forget the newly Instagram.